In this video, we are going to discuss parallelization of a digital IR filter. See, we'll discuss with an example. Develop parallel realization for a given transfer function h object. H object is given, h object equal to 1 plus 2 into z to the power minus 1 plus z to the power minus 2 divided by 1 minus 0.75 z to the power minus 1 plus 0.125 z to the power minus 2. So realize in terms of parallel realization means we have to follow partial fraction expansion method. So for that we have to express given system function in positive power subject. Observe the numerator and denominator polynomial z to the power minus 2 is there. Because of that reason, I am going to multiply the numerator polynomial and denominator by z square. So after multiplying this much, we are getting, then for the simplification I am going to express in terms of h of z by z. This one, taking the z, it is not possible. Because of that reason, I am going to multiply the denominator terms of both side by z. So we are getting h of z by z equal to z square plus 2z plus 1 divided by z into this much. Then factorize this one. We are getting roots. Find the roots. Z minus 0.5 into z minus 0.25 we are getting. Then h of z by z equal to, there are three poles. Z equal to 0. That is, first pole is at z equal to 0. Second pole is z equal to 0.5. Third pole is p3 equal to z equal to 0.25. Hence, we are having three constants, a1 by z, a2 by z minus 0.5, a3 by z minus 0.25. Let us calculate the constant values a1, a2, a3. Then we are getting a1 equal to 8, a2 equal to 18, a3 equal to minus 25. Let us substitute here h of z by z equal to a1 is 8 by z plus a2 is 18 divided by z minus 0.5, a3 is minus 25 divided by z minus 0.25. Here I'm going to take this z towards RHS side. It becomes z get cancels, 18 z divided by z minus 0.5 minus 25 z divided by z minus 0.25. that step is written here. Then express in terms of negative power of z, that is h of z is equal to 8. What happens? It becomes 18 divided by 1 minus 0.5 z to the power minus 1, then minus 25 divided by 1 minus 0.25 z to the power minus 1. It means how many system functions we have here? We have 3. 1, 2, 3. That is h1 of z plus h2 of z plus h3 of z. So the given input sequence is applied simultaneously or passed to 3 system functions. Those are h1 of z, h2 of z and h3 of z. Okay, and we have to add all these 3. Finally we'll get y of n. So let us step by step, one by one, these system functions realize in terms of DF2. First, 8 is there. So 8 means constant term. X of n is multiplied by 8. X of n is multiplied by 8. Next, coming to second system function. What is that? One time delay. And coefficient term minus 0.5 is there. We have to take opposite sign, that is plus 0.5 added with the previous result. Okay, fine. Then here constant term 1 is there, constant term 1. Then coming to the zero system is what? 18 is there. Zero system, we have to represent. This is pole system and followed by zero system, 18 here. It is H2 object. It is H1 object. It is H2 object. Similarly, go for S3 object. For S3 object, one time delay, coefficient term is minus 0.25 is there. We have to take opposite of that. That is plus 2.25. One time delay, minus 0.25 is there. So take opposite of that, plus 0.25, add with the previous result, constant term is 1 is there. And what about zero system? Zero system is minus 25 there. Zero system is what? Minus 25 there. So zero system will come here. It is minus 25. Here I realized each and every system functions, those are h1 object, h2 object, h3 object, separately in terms of df2. It is h1 object, it is h2 object, it is h3 object. We have to add all these three. Will give what? Will give y of n. So adding. For this, what we are applying? We are applying x of n. Okay. It is what? It is the parallel realization of what? Given system function. Thank you. Thank you very much.